Dementia is a devastating illness impacting the lives of a growing number of people. The sickness not only impacts the lives of those who suffer, but also their families and carers. This is especially the case with the Indigenous population, where the rate of dementia is much greater than the national average, and often the onset is at a younger age.
Dementia is a broad or global term for deterioration of function in the brain, both thinking, cognition, what we call planning, that type of function, but also social ability to look after oneself in society, ability to relate, ability to look after your own personal care or do your own what we call ADLs, activities of daily living. So it's a combination of cognitive dysfunction or loss of memory, but also changes in personality and emotion.
Yeah, my late husband had it. It was very early stages, but and I knew there was something wrong, and because he just kept going. He was going for long walks and didn't even know, you know, why.
The hard times with Blot, especially my mum, is the days when she doesn't remember me. That is really hard, and some days we do have that.
Our project is called the Koori Dementia Care Project, and that actually is about building capacity around dementia in six specific urban and regional communities in New South Wales. And those communities were chosen because they are part of a bigger study called the Koori Growing Old Well Study. And so it's about translating the research that has come out of that study, and then using that to create capacity, build resources for those Aboriginal communities.
We decided that it was important to look at the rates of dementia in urban Aboriginal people. Now, a couple of previous studies were done some time ago, one 15, 20 years ago, looking at the population in Cape York, which showed 20% rate of dementia, 65 years and over, which was about four times the non-Indigenous rate. Then in the Kimberley, maybe 5 years ago, a very important study was published on remote people, very different to our urban population because they're mostly non-English speaking, or at least English as a second language. Many had never been to school. They live closer to their cultural roots, if you like. And that showed three to four times the rate of non-Indigenous people. But we thought we should look at where the most Aboriginal people live in our society, and that is in urban situations. Most actually live in New South Wales. The majority of those actually live in metropolitan Sydney. So we looked at two areas in metropolitan Sydney and three up on the mid-north coast to get a span of people, five communities, and we decided to look at the rate of dementia, the causes of dementia, how to diagnose dementia, and what to do for people with dementia, and how to build capacity in those communities.
I guess the hypothesis is that it really is an across the life issue, and there may be multiple factors impacting on that crest incidence that may range from, you know, sort of even prenatal care right across the life cycle, leading up to transition illness points in mid-age, and, you know, socioeconomic factors. So indeed, the study, the Koori Growing Old Well study, is trying to extrapolate some of those things. And indeed, the detail that they've extracted will assist in trying to understand perhaps some of those things for the future.
In fact, dementia, like most chronic diseases, is very, we believe, environmental in origin. It very much relates to early life events like level of education, level of upbringing, because we grow kids' brains and they grow throughout life. So the first, I think, most important thing that's going to happen in reducing dementia or delaying dementia, we're not going to stop it, is the gradually improving level of education of society, will improve brain function the minute it comes on a bit later, and that is an enormous public health impact. I think closing the gap in many ways, as well as reducing the amount of early onset dementia that's occurring in Aboriginal people, because we believe they don't only get it more often, they get it a bit earlier, will depend on good education, good skill jobs, not digging ditches or labouring jobs, getting into the workforce, completing high school, getting into trades, getting into university, having more Aboriginal doctors, nurses, educators. That's what needs to happen, and we think that will reduce the rate of dementia, as I believe it has done in the non-Indigenous community.
I mean, what is the importance of looking after older Aboriginal people? I guess my view of that would be that most importantly, it's about equity.